Ellarigu namaskara, welcome and welcome back to my channel. I don't know if you guys will notice this, or maybe you notice that after I start pointing out again the inner part of my fake lashes are coming off. It's not so visible on camera, so I'm just rolling with it. It is so hard to put on lashes. Like, how do people wear it in every single video? I only wore it because it just make this look extra, so I just wore it. I love the way fake lashes look, but wearing them, it takes me like 20 to 30 minutes to put on lashes. So I'm like, I would rather just wear mascara, like 3 or 4 coats of mascara, and let my lashes be rather than wearing fake lashes. But I still love the way fake lashes look. So just like ignore the inner corner, only look at the outer corner that are like super flared out and sexy. So speaking of mascara, today's video is going to be a review on the Maybelline Total Temptation mascara, as well as, oh my god, how long have I been waiting for this product? Like, you guys will know. If you have been watching me at least from the beginning of the year, you guys know how desperately I've been waiting for this product. So finally, it's here in India. So without further ado, let's just hop onto the video. I do have try-ons of both the products, but the try-on was, I did it on a different day. So when I was getting ready, I just used these products and I filmed it with my iPad. So the angle may be a little off, but still you can see the product and product in complete action. So I'm going to insert that as I speak about the product. So first, let's start off with the mascara. This is the Maybelline Total Temptation mascara, and this is waterproof. It comes in this beautiful baby blue packaging, and I really like the packaging because it's very sturdy, and I like the cap of it because it's a single shape. That way it's really easy to hold and apply. Speaking of the product packaging, this is what the wand looks like. It's a generic wand. It looks almost, let me show you. Okay, so I have the Maybelline Hyper Curl here, and they look almost identical, except the Maybelline Hyper Curl has a little bit of curl here, and the Temptation one is a little straight, and the bristles here are far apart, whereas the bristles on the Total Temptation are very close together. In terms of the shape, it resembles the Maybelline Hyper Curl, and in terms of the bristles, it resembles this Essence False Lashes mascara, which I'm going to show you in a second. So the bristles of these are very identical. Even I would say the Maybelline one is a little more packed, and it's a little more spaced out than this one. So, but they are very identical. So if you have one of the two, then maybe you will know, you will be able to gauge what they actually look like. And the product itself, it has a very subtle coconut fragrance, which I actually enjoy. It's very subtle, it's not over the top. I'm so sorry for the background noise. This construction has been going on since morning. Oh, I'm so annoyed. So it has this very faint, not coconut oil scent, but coconut scent. It's very pleasant, and when you apply it on your lashes, it does linger. At least, okay, basically my nose is a dog's nose, and I can literally smell anything and everything because my nose is very sensitive, so I can smell a lot of things. That is why I'm able to smell this even after putting the mascara on. So some of you may like it, some of you may not like it. The mascara itself, it gives a lot of volume, and it also does give a little bit of length. The one thing that I absolutely don't like about this mascara is, holy shit, it transfers. Now, it says that it is waterproof, and I have noticed this with washable mascaras from Maybelline, because I have tried, I think, 2 or 3 of my favorite variants from Maybelline. I've tried the Push-Up Drama in the washable one. I've tried Lash Sensational in the washable one, as well as the Hyper Curl. All three of them I've tried in the washable version as well. The difference that I noticed between waterproof and washable in terms of its formula is the amount it transfers. So all the washable versions transfer a lot on me, not in terms when I wear the mascara and throughout the day it transfers when I actually apply the mascara and I put my lashes up like this. They transfer onto my lid, and even without that, they transfer a lot onto my lid, which I've noticed is a very common occurrence in a lot of washable mascaras, even the Essence one. But this claims to be waterproof. Even with a waterproof claim, it does sort of transfer. It doesn't curl your lashes or hold the curl. I only tried this once or twice with my lash color, and then my lash color gave up, obviously. But still, it doesn't hold your curl the 1 or 2 times that I tried with the lash color. And the formula, I have noticed this again across board with almost all Maybelline mascaras. the first few times you use it, they're going to be brand new and they're going to be a little on the wet side, and it does not perform to its full potential. But after a month or 3 weeks, once a little bit of air gets in, it starts to get a little moosey, and once it gets moosey, it performs to its true potential. And that is what I've noticed with this mascara as well. Again, this is no exception. For example, I had this Maybelline Push Up Drama mascara. This is like, I think, my third or fourth tube, if I'm not wrong. And the I am using this again almost after 6-8 months because I had a lot of mascaras in rotation. And when I first used this, I'm like, I don't remember why this was my favorite. It's just okay and it transfers a lot and all that, even though this is again washable, I mean waterproof version. But then after a month or so of using it, a little bit of air got in and it got a little moosier, and it is performing as well as I remember it being. So yeah, that is one of the things that you should keep in mind with, I think, any mascara. That's the case with Essence. I like their formula straight off the bat, but they do dry a little quickly because they're already halfway through their shelf life, and the other half they perform. And I hope you know what I'm saying. Like, when you open Essence mascaras brand new, they're already moussey, and so if the mascara's lifespan is 3 months, it has already had its 1.5 months span time. Whereas in Maybelline, with the 3 months is the span time, within a month or month and a half it slowly starts to dry up and then it performs to its full potential. But the Essence, right off the tube, it performs amazingly, but only lasts like a month or 2 months, or it doesn't last fully because it gets dried up pretty quickly. I hope you are understanding what I'm trying to say. In terms of the packaging, I really like it. In terms of the actual formula and its performance, I would rate it as okay. It is still better than the Big Shot mascara that I tried at the beginning of the year. I had reviewed a Master Chrome highlighter and a Maybelline mascara that time. I mean, that was a first impression. So you guys can check it out if you're interested. I will leave a link to it in the description box below. Great. There is no light and the power just went. But I'm still going to film because why not? So this one is sort of just okay. This is one step above Maybelline Big Shot, but not as good as, let's say, Lash Sensational or Push Up Drama. This would still fall under the third, this one, rather than the Maybelline Hypercurl. Maybelline Hypercurl is no longer my favorite because it doesn't perform. I mean, I've found mascaras even from the house of Maybelline that perform way better. So I am not going to recommend Maybelline Hypercurl. This is okay. So if you're like basically bored of trying all Maybelline mascaras, like you have tried everything from Maybelline and you want to try something new, then you would go for this. That's what I did when I was in the hunt for a new mascara. The Lash Temptational released in India and I'm like, add to cart, you know. But I wouldn't necessarily like suggest you guys to go out of your way to buy it because it's not as good as Lash Sensational or Push Up Drama. Overall, I would give it like a 3 or 3.0 out of 5, not more than that. Next, let's talk about the highlight of this video, pun intended. Okay, so this is the Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter and this is in the shade Molten Rose Gold. I've been telling, ever since the Molten Gold version released, I have been like, if ever rose gold came to India, I am going to buy it. So basically I was on a no makeup buy for almost a month, and even in October I was like, no, I'm not going to buy. But at the end of October, this bad boy released and I'm like, I've been waiting so long for this, like how can I not buy it? Because I was so desperate to get my hands on it. So I thought, when my friends are coming from States in December, I thought I would get this from them because this is available in States. But then Maybelline released it in India. I'm like, why should I wait till December or December end? I can just buy it right now. Again, this is the same. Oh, I forgot to tell you the price of the mascara. This retails for either 525 or 550 rupees. So it's the same standard pricing of all Maybelline mascaras. Again, this one is no exception. Oh, see, now again it came back. So this Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter in the shade Rose Gold, this also retails for 550 rupees. The packaging is pretty much the same, and this shade I thought would be, since it is rose gold, I thought it would be very close in tone to one of my favorite highlighters, which is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow highlighter in the shade Precious Petals. But it is not. This is a lighter pink in comparison to that. Basically in the pan they look identical, but they look very similar, but that does not, identical was the wrong word. So this one and the Wet n Wild one look almost similar, except the Wet n Wild has a touch more pink than this one. But oh my god, this Okay, so I have come to realize that the Master Chrome in the shade Molten Gold, if I apply a little too much, then it looks yellow on my cheeks. So I have, this is something that I've noticed. It's still a very beautiful highlighter and it is still one of my favorites. But I knew once the Rose Gold came in, this would knock it out of that first place and this would take its place instantly. The moment I put this on my face, I knew she was the one. I knew that she would fulfill all the she would like fulfill all of my wishes and dreams, and she would fill the void that no other highlighter could possibly fill. I know I'm being a little dramatic, so actually this is the highlighter I have on right now. Again the power bit, damn it, just like get used to it, you know, this will keep happening on and off. I don't know what is wrong. Power has been going on since morning. Power has been going on and off. So this is super reflective, and again with the Master Chrome highlighters, be it the gold one or the rose gold one, it does show up a lot lighter on your skin than it does in the pan, and it is super 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 reflective. It makes your cheeks look wet looking and it's just so beautiful. I just love this. There was no way I would not love this product because I knew I would love it, and I think I'm giving a little bit of a biased view, but I don't care. I love this. And it just makes your skin look like it is really healthy and glowing, and it has that natural, your skin is naturally healthy and glowing, and it gives that natural look. If you go a little bit on your cheekbones, this is pretty much good for everyday use or on your bare skin or like full glam, whatever. I have this in my inner corner, it is giving that beaming highlighter. I have it on my cheekbones. I don't know how well you can tell, but I do have it on my cheekbones and it does perform beautifully on the cheek as well. You can make it very 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 subtle. You can just take a fan brush and just go once and nicely buff it out. It will look like a very nice sheen. Or you could take a denser brush and like pack it on, or even with a fan brush you could pack it on, and it will look intense and gorgeous on your skin. And I think this would suit most of the skin tones. It's not like the Molten Gold one would not suit people who had very 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 fair skin, and I think the Rose Gold one will suit across board. I have a feeling it doesn't really have that pink color like the Molten Gold one has that base yellow color. This doesn't really have one, so I am like so happy that this is in my collection. I am so excited to get ready every morning because I get to wear this and it just looks beautiful on the skin. If you love the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Precious Petals, you in terms of color, you will absolutely love this. It's very close, but I would still say you need to have both. Like I am that person because I'm not really a highlighter person, but I am actually telling you guys that you can have the Precious Petals one and the Molten Rose Gold one and they will look different, you know. And if you like the Maybelline Master Chrome Master Molten Gold highlighter, the formula and the way it looks on your skin, then again you would absolutely love this because they're similar in formula, almost they are same in terms of formula, except the way it looks and the color is what varies. So if you liked either Precious Petals or Molten Gold, I would suggest you would absolutely love this. And even if you have both of them, I am still telling you guys to go pick this up because the Master Chrome Molten something highlighters, these are okay. Now my real life had to die. Okay, so these are like no other that I've ever tried. It doesn't really look like anything on your skin, but your skin just looks absolutely beautiful. So 100% I would suggest you guys, like I'm convincing you guys so much to buy this, like buy it, you guys will not regret it. So with that, we come to the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. And also, if you have tried either of these, make sure to leave it in the comments down below. And then, what else should you guys do? Let me write a list and give you. So please subscribe and I will see you in my next one. Bye.